With Windows 10 being discontinued, a lot of people are considering switching to Linux, an alternative operating system to Windows and Mac that you're probably hearing a lot about right now. Hi, I'm a dead content creator who left as a normal person and returned as a Linux cultist. I want to prove that Linux is not as hard as some people think, and that the meme of having to type 1,000 commands to launch a browser is, and always has been, completely wrong. This video is the first in a series, and we'll cover if Linux is right for you, and some of the benefits of switching. Without further ado, let's talk about some of the reasons you can't or probably shouldn't switch to Linux. Do you absolutely need Windows to run stuff that's essential to your life? For example, if you need to use Adobe products, which is unfortunate, but I get it, then they've historically had terrible compatibility on Linux. If you have to use Lockdown Browser or some other kind of specific educational software as a student, then just running Linux is not a great idea. Some people would say that dual booting is an option, and maybe in that second scenario that might work out, but it leads to a lot of headaches and wasted space. Do you play games that just straight up don't work on Linux because of anti-cheat? Apex Legends, Destiny 2, Battlefield 6, Rainbow Six Siege, and every Riot game all don't work on Linux. For my personal taste, that pretty much does me a favor if anything, but if any of those games is a deal breaker, I get it. If you want to check, there's a website called ProtonDB where you can search for individual games, or you can log in via your Steam account and look at your whole library in one go. Golden above is typically the standard for it pretty much being just like it is on Windows, but Silver can sometimes be worked with as well. Anything lower than that, I would not recommend. Finally, do you need every frame squeezed out of your games? You may have heard of the Lenovo Legion Goat getting better frame rates using SteamOS instead of Windows, but that's because of a very specific set of circumstances from what I've seen and understand. In reality, on most desktops with GPUs, you'll see a minor to rather large dip in performance, especially if you have an NVIDIA GPU, which, according to the Steam Hardware Survey, is a large amount of you. If you're already struggling to run games, until more game companies start supporting native Linux games, you're probably better off on Windows. Okay, hopefully all the people who had unworkable deal breakers are gone now, and I can explain why Linux is so nice. Its customization is unparalleled. Sure, there's some random stuff you can download on Windows to add little things here or there, but Linux gives you complete control. If you hop on r/unix, then you can see what crazy stuff people have done. Ever want to boot up and look like you're on the Minecraft title screen? You can do that. This person made it so when you open a program, it comes from a portal like in Rick and Morty. It's absolutely insane what you can do. You can also just go for a nice minimalist look that feels cozy to you. You can spend a lot of time crafting something that resonates with you specifically. I genuinely cannot express how awesome it is to express yourself with your setup and how comfortable it is to use when you've shaped everything to your liking. I genuinely find it painful to navigate and get anything done in Windows now because of how comfortable my setup is. I was babysitting one day and one of the kids wanted to draw on the computer. I did this. All I had to do was type a little easy to remember prefix and then what I wanted to install. And she was like, "Wait, you did it already?" Installing stuff on Linux is so nice. You can kind of get the same thing done on Windows with Chocolaty, but it doesn't have nearly the support that Linux packages have. Not to mention that to update, I literally just go to my terminal, type update, and let it rock, updating pretty much everything on my system in one command. It's kind of like on your phone where you have an app store where you go to update stuff and download stuff, but on mega steroids. This is opposed to how people typically install things on Windows, where you have to open your browser, search for the thing you want to download, click the download button, click on the executable, tell the installer to run anyway because Windows tries to protect you, wait for the installer to install it, then go back to your downloads and delete the installer that you don't need anymore. It's such a hassle, and actually harder than Linux when you think about it. Finally, it's been said 1,000 times by thousands of people, but you just get away from Microsoft's increasing amount of crap. A fresh Windows install usually results in having to run someone else's script to try and turn off and delete as much of Microsoft's stuff as possible. When you update, sometimes that random crap reinstalls itself and you have to debloat it again. Linux will never do that, since it's not trying to serve you ads on your own computer. Even the most bloated Linux distro just means that it comes with a lot of useful programs pre-installed, not that it comes with ads and telemetry spying on you as you use your computer. So I hope this video helped inspire you to at least try out Linux. It's a fascinating rabbit hole, as well as providing you genuine benefits that improve your computer experience. If you're ready to learn how to install it, I'm going to link the next video in this series where I explain what my recommended distro is and why, as well as how to install any Linux distro. Thanks for watching. I'll see you over there.